So where do ideas live? I mean, besides living in our brains, how do they travel? And I think that nowadays, in the age of information, right, they're information files, they're binary bits, so they're ones and zeros. So today we make content, we make media. I mean, Gene Youngblood, who wrote a seminal book called Expanded Cinema, says that cinema reflects mankind's historical drive to manifest his consciousness outside of his mind in front of his eyes. So content, media, cinema is a mirror we hold up to ourselves. These information files, these pieces of content that we create and send out into the world to create ripples, are real things that infect brain. Ideas, they build on top of each other, right? So everything might have like a simple beginning, and then it can sort of, its complexity can grow. Somebody once had the idea, man can fly. And then somebody had the idea, sure, let's build a craft with wings. And then somebody was like, yeah, we can harness the properties of the wind and flight and so on and so forth. And, you know, the ideas build. They all start with sort of a simple desire. What do you want to do? How do you want to transform the world? When you wake up in the morning and you think, what can I come up with? What is a unique vision that I can contribute to humanity that starts simple and that can grow? You know, when I go to the theater and watch a film like Inception, I'm in awe, not just at the ideas that are explored, the ideas that literally spill over and burst through the screen and give me an epiphany, but I'm also impressed by the design and the visual effects, the way those ideas are portrayed in this narrative that becomes real, you know? I mean, who doesn't like to be held in aesthetic arrest, to be frozen by something that moves you, to be dumbstruck by awe, to be pushed to the limits by an IMAX film of the Hubble Space Telescope showing you the infinity of the cosmos in 3D, and you're sitting there watching it, gawking at the ubiquitous wonders that exist at all times in the entire universe that we're culturally conditioned to ignore. How sad is it that due to hedonic adaptation and our overly busy lives, we fail to apprehend the awe of the infinity that surrounds us at every moment. Evolutionary success when it comes to our genes used to be to spread our genes widely, right? Mate, spread ourselves, that's evolutionary success. Mark your territory, so to speak. I mean, it sounds crude, but that's, human beings are designed to replicate. So I think anytime that you can maximize the spaces in which ideas can come together and collide and intermingle, you are participating almost in an evolutionary process, an acceleration of new possibilities, maximizing possibilities in every direction. Don't stop searching until you find it, because that should be your guiding principle. You know, find an idea, find a vision that just moves you to your core, you know? Camus used to say life should be lived to the point of tears. So find that thing that brings you to tears. Find that beatific vision, that truth, that moment of aha. Chase it, and when you find it, run with it.